Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Basic of ServiceNow Learning. There are some handful methods and properties to get the logged in user details. So through g_user, we can access these properties which are mentioned in orange color, like first name, last name, user ID, username. Okay, and the content which is mentioned in green color is the methods of GLAD user API, which we can also access through g_user object. So let's see what is the use case for today. So the today scenario is that if the user have the required role, then only he can access the email field available in incident form. Otherwise, the email field become read only for him. So below are the basically four methods which we are implementing in today's use case or in today's scenario. So let's navigate to ServiceNow application to understand the use case scenarios and to implement the below methods. So friend, this is my ServiceNow personal developer instance. So let's open the form to understand the scenario first. So let's see the incident. So as per the scenario, if the user having a specific role, then only he can modify the email field, or he is able to write in email field. Otherwise, this field will become read only for him. So let's add one more thing, that if user modify the category to some category and he is having a specific role, then he is able to modify the specific field. Otherwise, this field will become read only for him. So to implement this, let's navigate to client script, because we know that we can use g_user object in client script or in UI policies. So as per the scenario, on the change of category, if the user have a specific role, then he is able to write in email field. Otherwise, email field become read only. So let's see. We are going to implement it incident table. So I am selecting incident over here. Here the type is on change, because on the change of category we are doing. So here we have to write the code. So let's see what is the first use case. The first use case is g_user.hasRole. So here it is mentioned that this particular method will return true if the current user has the specific role or the specified role, or the user is admin. So let's navigate to the client script section. Let's implement over here. If g_user.hasRole, I am mentioning some other role over here is, so before going to role, let's figure out the role section first for user. So I am opening a user. So this demo one and admin, I am using these two users to validate the functionality and to give understanding on a role section. So this demo one user is only having a role, that is so demo role 1, and this admin user does not have this role, demo role 1 or demo role 2. Okay, so let's keep in mind when I am doing coding so that it will be easy for you to understand it. So let's move to a client script. So in this scenario, I am giving demo role 2, so both the users does not have this role. Okay, so we are done with this method. Here we have mentioned that if the user has a specific role, then he is able to modify the field. Otherwise, it will give an alert message that he does not have the required role and that email field will become a read only. Okay, so let's save the client script. I am closing rest of the windows. Now I am validating this application, this particular functionality through admin user who does not have the role. Okay, so creating a new and I'm modifying the category. See, it displayed a message alert that user has a specified role or he is an admin user. Means the admin user does not have this role, but he is admin, so that's why he is able to access this field, email field. Now logged in with some other user. So in another browser, I have logged in through a demo one user. So demo one user have a demo role one, but he does not have a demo role two. So let's see how the application will look like to him, or how the email field will look like to him. So I'm clicking on create new. Here I'm changing the category to some network. So it is mentioning that does not have a required role, and I click on OK. See, this field become read only for him. So let's implement the other scenario, that is g_user.hasRole. Here it returns true if the current user has any role. Means if the user having a single role, it doesn't mean that what role he have. If he is having a single role, then the particular method will return true, otherwise return false. So let's implement this method. Navigate to client script. So what I am going to do is, I am just marking it as comment and adding different code. If so here we are done with this method has roles. So it means it will return true if the user having any role. Okay, so let's save the form and validate it. I am validating this to admin user first, because admin user is having a lots of role, so he is able to modify. I believe, see, user have at least one role, so he is able to modify the email field. Same we can validate in different user demo one. He is also able to modify this because I believe he is having a role. So see, user have at least one role, so he is able to modify the email field. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to implement a third use case, that is g_user_has_role_exactly. So let's navigate to the client script, closing other windows. g_user.hasRoleExactly. So I am done with this method. So it returns true only if the current user has the specified role. It means if the user is admin and he does not have this role, then he is not able to perform, or he is not able to write in the email field. This is also applicable for admin. So here I'll change the role to 1. So it means user 1 is having this role, but admin is not having this role. Let's see, save it. Navigating through admin, clicking on create new, modifying the category to some category, that is like this page is loading. Let the page load first. Hardware, see, it does not have the required role. Now this is not working for the admin as well. So in case if we want that a particular user will not perform any functionality, then we can use has role exactly, because it will, even if this role is not allowing an admin to perform any activity, right? Let's validate it from other user. Let's close it, because lots of windows are getting displayed, so it's pretty difficult to understand the thing, right? So I'm clicking on create new. So clicking on create new, basically reloading the page again and again. So I am changing the category, see, network, okay. So see, he is able to modify it because he is having a specific role. So let's navigate to some other scenario, the last scenario. Last scenario is that if g_user has role from list. So it means that it will return true if the current user has at least one role, okay, or he is admin. So if the user is admin, doesn't matter the whether the role is mentioned in the list or not, he is able to access the functionality. Okay, for other users, he need to have a role which is mentioned in the list. So let's implement this in client script. So here, let's close the window first. This is client script. Let's do a comment and write another script. G_user. The last is hasRoleFromList. So here I have mentioned that if the user have these two roles, then he is able to modify the email field, otherwise not. So this is basically applicable for admin, that admin can modify whether the role is mentioned in the list or not. Okay, so let's save it and modify from the user. I'm creating a new incident over here. So I'm changing the category. User has at least one role from a specified list. Okay, see, he is able to modify email. So here we don't have an admin role, but admin is able to modify the particular field, because as per as this method, admin can do anything, admin can access, right? So let's navigate to some other user. Let's create a new. So this user is having a role from this list. So user has at least one role from the specified list, and he is able to modify the email field. And vice versa, we can check if I am changing the role to some other role. And let's see whether he is able to modify or not, because the role which he is having not in the list now. Changing the category, does not have a role in the specified list. Email become read only. So friend, this is all for this video. I hope this video helped you to understand the required topic. So if you have not subscribed my channel, please do subscribe my channel, and please do not forget to click on bell icon, because after clicking on bell icon, you will receive the notifications of my upcoming ServiceNow videos. Thank you friends. Have a nice day. Bye bye.